Hello everyone, this is Bahrom and welcome. Welcome to the third part, English and Mathematics. In this part, you will get acquainted with the mathematical structure of English. Till this part, we have done everything through this table. We have done all the parts through this table. And from beginning to the end of this system, we will be doing all the lessons through this table. And that's the good news for you. It is good for you because the table contains all the subjects related to English grammar, not just active tenses. It has passive tenses, it has if clauses, modal verbs, etc. Okay, in the previous part, I showed you 5 formulas and I asked you to memorize them. I hope you did. I hope you memorized them because the formulas have an important role in using the 12 tenses here. We're going to use them everywhere. And now, I'm going to show you a very simple multiplication process. The process of how to get the main formulas of these tenses. Let me explain right away what I mean by multiplication process. For example, look at the present simple. Look at the present simple. Verb 1 is the main formula of present simple. And we can't change it. What about perfect? And let's assume that you don't know what is present perfect is. You don't know them. Let's assume that you don't know this tense. No problem. Just focus on the name of the tense. Just focus on the name. It says present and perfect, right? Present and perfect. All you have to do is just write the formulas of present and perfect. Just write them down. The names of the tenses give you clues about which formulas to write. So, this is the present formula, verb 1, and the perfect formula, have verb 3. As you see, I have written the formulas based on the names of the tenses, present and perfect. Now, I will show you multiplication and try to learn how to do it. Multiply verb 1 with have. The first form of have. What is the first form of have? It is have or has, right? Have has. And as a result of this multiplication process, you will get the main formula of present perfect, which is have has verb 3. This is the main formula of present perfect tense. Let's do the same multiplication to the present continuous. Let's find out what is the main formula of present continuous by doing this multiplication. And of course, let's assume that you don't know what is present continuous. All you have to do is just focus on the name again, name of the tense, and of course, the formulas. If you struggle to remember them, you can check out from the table. Write the formula of present and continuous and multiply them. Remember, multiplication should be like this. It should be like this, not like this. We have only one type of multiplication, and it is the same everywhere in this system and cannot be changed. The first form of be is M is R. Verb 1, you should multiply verb 1 with be. What is the first form of be? It is M is R, right? So that it's kind of an abbreviation of M is R. Be is M is R. The result, M is R verbing. M is R verb ing. The main formula of continuous is M is R verbing and cannot be changed. We're going to use this formula whenever we want to use present continuous. Okay, let's have a look at the present perfect continuous. Present perfect continuous, one of the difficult tenses in English grammar. We've got 3 names, right? We have 3 names, present, perfect, and continuous. So what are we going to do? Well, we do the same thing again. We will follow the same procedure again. The order of the formulas should be according to the order of the names here. Please do not confuse this. Present, verb 1, perfect, have verb 3, and continuous, be verb ing. The multiplication order should be like this. This is very important, otherwise you will get different results. And look at the shapes here. Look at these red shapes. This is how it should be. This is how you're going to multiply the formulas. So, the first form of have is have has. The third form of be is been. You should reflect the properties of verb 3 to be. The third form of be is been, right? That's why I brought here been. Have has been verb ing. That's the result. So why didn't we do anything about verb ing here? Why didn't we do anything? Well, there is nothing that we can multiply it, right? So there is nothing that we can multiply it. The main formula of present perfect continuous is have, has, been, verb ing. Now, let's look at some more difficult tense. Let's look at the past tense here, the past simple. What is the main formula of the past simple? You can check out from the table, verb 2, right? So this is the main formula of past simple. All right, what about past perfect? This tense might be difficult to many of you, but thanks to this multiplication process, it is not difficult to solve the structure of this tense. And is the multiplication process going to work here as well? Actually, this is a good opportunity to test it. Past perfect, past, verb 2, perfect, have verb 3. What is the past form of have? What is the second form of have? It is had, right? Had. The result will be had verb 3. So, had verb 3 is the main formula of past perfect and cannot be changed. All right, let's do this multiplication process or processes a little faster because I think you understand it. You understand the main idea of this multiplication process. Okay, have a look at the past continuous. Past, verb 2, continuous, be verb ing. The past form of be is was were. The second form of be is was were. Was were, verb ing. This is the main formula and you can't change it. Main formula is was were, verbing. What about past perfect continuous? Verb 2, have verb 3, and be verbing. And by the way, do not forget to write them in parentheses. We use parentheses when we multiply them. The second form of have is had. The third form or past participle form of be is been. The third form of be is been. The result is had been verb ing. And it is the main formula of past perfect continuous. We're going to use this formula in past perfect continuous. All right. Future simple, will verb infinitive is the main formula. Future perfect, future, will verb infinitive, perfect, have verb 3. Remember the multiplication should be like this. The end of the parenthesis and the beginning of the other parenthesis. You can check out it from other multiplications too. Multiply verb infinitive with have. Infinitive form of have. Or base form of have is have. The result of this multiplication will be will have verb 3. And this is the formula of future perfect. What about future continuous? Will verb infinitive and be verb ing. Infinitive form of be is be. And the result will be verb ing. And finally, we have future perfect continuous here. One of the most difficult tenses in English. But in this system, trust me, it is not difficult. All you have to do is just write the formulas in order. Future will verb infinitive, perfect have verb 3, continuous be verb ing. Multiply them. Infinitive form of have is have, and the third form of be is been. Result will have been verb ing. And this is the main formula of future perfect continuous. Okay, we have tenses, formulas, multiplications, and the results. Your duty in this part is to practice this multiplication process. Take a pen and paper, draw the table, write down the formulas in it, write the tenses, write formulas based on their names, and do this multiplication process. Do it without looking at any notes. Find the main formulas of all tenses. And remember, we are just going step by step. This is the third step of this system. And in the following lessons, it will be completed. In the next part, I will show you how to detect the tenses of the sentence. Detecting the tenses of the sentence in your own language is really important. I don't know your mother tongue. I don't know what language you speak. But it's very important to know how to detect the tenses of your sentence. And I'll show you the easiest way of how to detect, how to find out the tense of your sentence. Okay, I will see you in the next lesson.